In April, scientists unveiled an artificial womb undergoing testing on fetal lambs, with a prediction from one of the researchers that the technology could be ready for human testing in 3 to 5 years. Artificial wombs suddenly became the most unexpected rage of 2017. But what sort of artificial wombs might realistically be a part of healthcare in the near future? In science fiction, artificial wombs are often depicted as self-sufficient systems that develop an individual from a small bundle of cells to a living, breathing infant, or sometimes, well beyond. But although some research has been conducted on artificially replicating the conditions of early pregnancy, a complete artificial womb is destined to remain science fiction for quite some time. The artificial womb shown to the world in April has a much more focused application, a support system, or a second womb, for prematurely born babies who would otherwise find themselves struggling to survive in the outside world as early as 22 or 23 weeks into development. Lambs that were tested in this system successfully developed in the same way as if they had never left their original biological environment. Described this way, artificial wombs do not sound particularly controversial. Why would anyone object to what is essentially a massively upgraded and more effective neonatal incubator? Nonetheless, the implications of this technology improving beyond its current state has set off waves of excitement and alarm in a surprisingly diverse set of groups. It turns out that artificial wombs are the social controversy equivalent of 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon, except all debates are connected to artificial wombs in a single degree. Researchers are excited that this technology could save many lives, significantly increasing the number of premature babies who survive. But some doctors worry it could result in increasing the number of people born each year who will struggle with crippling lifelong problems. Folks who tend to go under the titles of men's rights and red pill activists, and who frequently are not the biggest fans of the opposite sex, see artificial wombs as their chance to finally render women's reproductive power obsolete. Segments of the feminist community have long been intrigued by artificial wombs for their potential to remove some of the burden of pregnancy. But there is also concern among feminists and pro-choice advocates about what artificial wombs could mean for the abortion debate. In the United States, for example, the legality of abortion is significantly based off of the concept of viability, whether or not the fetus could survive outside the womb. But if this technology were to improve, it could push back viability much earlier in pregnancy. On the pro-life side of things, there is excitement that artificial wombs could disrupt some of the core rationales for keeping abortion legal. But there is also concern in conservative corners that artificial wombs might end up redefining much of birth and parenthood itself, and, down the line, end up decoupling birth from sexuality and gender entirely. Other individuals are warning about the economic dangers of artificial wombs. Could their development drive an additional wedge between the rich and poor, creating a class of individuals who give birth the old-fashioned way, and a select few who only carry their fetus through the first few weeks of pregnancy? What would all this mean for laws regarding maternity leave and the workplace? Would there be any psychological effects for a fetus that spends a chunk of its development away from its mother in a high-tech plastic bag? Whew! There sure is a lot to worry about for something that is, on its face, a great thing. Which is perhaps why the researchers of this most recent study have stressed repeatedly that they have no desire to use this technology beyond the current limits of viability. It's important to remember that this technology won't revolutionize everything we know about birth overnight. In fact, it's entirely possible that this artificial womb will become a reality in hospitals without disrupting societal norms any more than the introduction of the incubator did in the early 1900s. Nonetheless, we have to ask, are you interested in the prospect of artificial wombs, or would you rather not open Pandora's box? If you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe, and check out our other videos. Thanks for watching!